Hello everyone, today I am really grateful that I got a chance to present this wonderful subject about underwater acoustics and sensor network and architecture. So let me give you a small introduction about the subject so that you could get a small outlook about the subject. The main contents are introduction, underwater sensor network architecture, propagation of underwater sensor network, advantages, issues and challenges regarding underwater sensor networks, conclusion and future works. The underwater acoustic is a study of propagation of sound in water and the interaction of mechanical waves that constitute sound with water, its contents and its boundaries. It consists of number of sensor node vehicle deployed underwater, which is used to monitor underwater conditions. It is also known as underwater acoustic network, UAN, or underwater acoustic communication. Also, there are so many applications in this subject. So the first application is oceanographic data collection. These are collected using both SITU method and remote sensing. And the second application is disaster prevention. It refers to take measures to eliminate the root cause that make people vulnerable to disaster. The third application is assisted navigation. It is a system that often significantly improves the startup performance, that is, time to first feed of the GPS satellite based on the positioning system. The fifth application, pollution and environment monitoring. It is based on scientific observation of changes that occur in our environment. And finally, the sixth application, scientific exploration in underwater environment. So these are several applications that we can see in our UAS. Also, there are two types of USN architecture techniques. The first one is UWSN architecture. These networks are constituted by sensor nodes that are anchored to the bottom of the sea ocean. They are also used for environment monitoring or monitoring of underwater plates in tectonics. And another architecture method is 3D UWSN architecture. This network includes sensor node whose depth can be controlled by means of the different techniques they used for surveillance application or monitoring of ocean phenomena. And so we have two graph of this architecture methods. Propagation of underwater sensor networks. Also, there are many environmental factors affect acoustic communication. They are long propagation delay, environmental noise, path loss, Doppler spread, multipath effect. These are some advantages of UAS. It can be used for early warnings of tsunamis. It avoids data spoofing. It avoids privacy leakage. Pollution monitoring, and we have some photograph regarding this advantages given. Also, like all other fields, UASN have their own issues and challenges, so that it is an emerging field. Let's call out some of them. Communication method, acoustic or non-electromagnetic signal, limited battery power, limited bandwidth, communication equipment cost, requirement of dense element deployment of the sensor, more prone to failure and propagation delay. UWSN has become one of the prime focuses for researchers. Although underwater sensor networks have been a tremendous amount of growth in the past few years, there is still room for ample contribution, particularly in the physical deployment system on large scale. Thank you everyone for being so attentive for the past few minutes. I hope that all of you have got some idea about UASN. Once again, thank you all.